Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yesh Chanzo. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 2nd of February. Ruckus in Indian Parliament as opposition amps up pressure over farm laws. Pakistan Supreme Court orders alleged Daniel Pearl killer moved from prison. And Taliban says fight will continue if international forces stay in Afghanistan. And now for all the details. Opposition parties, including the Congress and the Left on Tuesday, forced adjournment of proceedings of the upper house of Indian Parliament as they insisted on taking up a discussion on the issue of farmers' protest over the three new farm laws. Meanwhile, security has been stepped up with the deployment of extra personnel and strengthening of barricades on the outskirts of Indian capital, where thousands of farmers have been protesting for over 2 months.
Proceedings in the Rajya Sabha, the upper house of the Indian Parliament, were adjourned for the day on Tuesday after opposition parties, including the Congress and the Left, created ruckus in the floor of the house over the three new contentious farm laws. The Speaker rejected the demand by the opposition for suspension of the day's business to discuss over 2 months long farmers' agitation at Indian capital's borders and said the issue can be taken up on Wednesday during motion of thanks on President's address, as the matter was referred in his speech last week. The ruckus eventually led to the adjournment of the House three times, and the proceeding will resume on Wednesday morning now.
हमने उस वक्त भी कहा था कि आप JPC के पास भेजिए, आप इसके बारे में डिस्कस करिए, तो वो तो उन्होंने किया नहीं. हमारी मांग है कि जब तक ये डिस्कशन नहीं हो, तब तक हम ये बातें लेकर ही सरकार के सामने ये बात रखेंगे और ये तीनों काले कानून वापस होने चाहिए, हमारी भूमिका है.
Meanwhile, police and paramilitary have dug ditches, spread razor wire and erected concrete and steel barricades across main roads into New Delhi to prevent protesting farmers entering the capital, a week after a farmers' tractor rally witnessed violence and a section of farmers breached into the historic Red Fort.
Kisan Andolan to aar-paar ki taraf hi ja raha. Isse pehle to yahan se uthte nahi.
The protesting farmers want the government to withdraw the three laws that they believe will hurt their livelihoods and benefit big corporations. The government, however, has rejected the demand, saying the reforms will open up new opportunities for them.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan's Supreme Court on Tuesday ordered authorities to move British-born Al-Qaeda terrorist Ahmed Omar Saeed Sheikh to a government rest house where he will be kept under security. Sheikh is the ringleader in the kidnapping and murdering of American journalist Daniel Pearl in 2002 and was acquitted by the court last year.
Pakistan's Supreme Court ordered the release from prison on Tuesday of Ahmed Omar Saeed Sheikh, a ringleader in the kidnapping and murder of US journalist Daniel Pearl by Al-Qaeda and Pakistan Islamist militants in 2002. Pakistan's government had appealed to the court on Friday to review its decision to free the British-born Islamist and three others convicted in the case, a day after their acquittal by a panel of three judges. The review panel, headed by Justice Umar Atta Bandyal, stood by the decision to acquit and recommended that Sheikh should be moved to a rest house before being fully released. As the government makes the arrangements in next 2 days, Sheikh will be kept in a comfortable environment in the jail with the permission to see his family, the court said. The
government representative insisted that he should not be released. The August Supreme Court of Pakistan has ordered that till next date of hearing, he may be kept under surveillance, supervision at some security place. But he should not be in the jail.
on assignment for the Wall Street Journal in the months after Al-Qaeda 9/11 attacks on the United States, Pearl was kidnapped in Karachi and later beheaded.
Moving on, over 100 government hospital workers in Gilgit-Baltistan recently held a protest to demand reinstatement after being fired from their jobs. They blamed they were hired when COVID-19 was at its peak in the illegally occupied region and were sacked without clearance of dues despite being on front lines during the pandemic for months.
Around 112 members of government hospital staff, including general nursing staff and lab and medical technicians, held a protest recently in illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan to demand reinstatement after being fired from their jobs. The protesters blamed they were hired when coronavirus was at its peak and have now been fired despite being on front lines during the pandemic for months. They appealed Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan and Gilgit-Baltistan authorities to reinstate them immediately and also demanded payment of their dues, which have been withheld.
Private hospitals mein kaam kar rahe the apne ilake mein jab corona uruj pe aaya to wahan se chhod ke yahan aaye the wahan se to ye berozgar ho chuke the pehle to aaj yahan se bhi hame berozgar kiya gaya hai hum purzor appeal karte hain wazirala sahab se ek dafa fir hame dobara se bahal kiya jaye
humne 6 mahine kaam kiya hai 6 mahinon mein hame 5 mahine ka tankha mila hai unme se ek mahine ka tankha bhi nahi mila hai to risk hum logon ne liya tha risk loss kisi aur ko mila hai.
The protesters blamed authorities of being apathetic towards their plight and said they feel they have been exploited as they went out of their way to work without caring for their safety during the pandemic.
In news from Afghanistan, the Taliban has said it will continue fighting if foreign forces remain in Afghanistan while reacting to reports that international troops can stay beyond the May deadline that was set in the February 2020 agreement with the United States.
The Afghan Taliban has said that they will continue defending the country if foreign forces remain beyond May deadline that has been set up based on a deal the group signed with the United States last year. The Taliban also reacted to a joint statement by the European Union and the other Afghan allies, including the United States, calling for an end of violence, especially targeted attacks. The militant group said that they will continue defending the values, the soil, the country and their rights if the US Taliban deal is not implemented. The remarks come as a media report quoting four senior NATO officials on Sunday said that international troops are planning to stay in Afghanistan beyond May. Meanwhile, the newly elected administration led by Joe Biden, after former President Donald Trump in the United States, has said that it is reviewing the US-Taliban agreement, mainly the Taliban's commitments to the Doha agreement. This comes as the second round of peace talks between the Afghan government and the Taliban in Doha that started on January 6 has seen no progress over the last 2 weeks, as the two sides have held no meeting to discuss the agenda during this period.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Attorney General of Nepal Agni Prasad Kharel, while defending Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli's dissolution of parliament decision, has said the Prime Minister had the power to do so if there was no possibility of forming an alternative government and that he was not obliged to seek a confidence vote. Now serving as the caretaker Prime Minister, Oli had in December dissolved the parliament following an internal rift in his ruling party.
Nepal's Attorney General Agni Prasad Kharel has defended Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli's move of dissolving the parliament, saying Oli had won the confidence of the House when he formed the government and the House never lost confidence in him. Pleading before the Supreme Court, Kharel on Monday said the phrase dissolution of the House of Representatives had been mentioned in independent clauses of the Constitution that mean that the PM had the power to dissolve the lower house of the parliament. Kharel said PM could dissolve the parliament if there was no possibility of forming an alternative government and that he was not obliged to seek a confidence vote. The Apex Court has issued two contempt of court notices to Oli, demanding he explain why he mocked lawyers challenging his decision to dissolve the parliament and call early polls. Now the caretaker PM Oli maintains he was forced to seek a fresh mandate through elections as the rift within his ruling Nepal Communist Party or NCP severely affected his government's functioning. Meanwhile, agitation against Oli's decision to dissolve the parliament continue across the country. In the latest, demonstrators in capital Kathmandu on Monday clashed with the police during the protests. Police scuffled with demonstrators and members of the All Nepal National Free Student Union, students' wing of ruling NCP, as they attempted to perform a flash mob in front of the parliament. NCP recently removed Oli's party membership after he did not respond to summons for his actions.
Ahead of the UN Human Rights Council's 46th session on February 22, where a number of country situation and topical matters will be taken up, the spotlight will once again be on Sri Lanka. The Human Rights Watch in its latest report said the Sri Lankan government is aggressively attacking efforts to hold officials to account for past grave abuses. Efforts to provide accountability significantly declined during 2020.
The Human Rights Watch, in its latest report released on Monday, said the Sri Lankan government is aggressively attacking efforts to hold officials to account for past grave abuses. The 93-page report examines efforts by the government of President Gotabaya Rajapaksa to thwart justice in seven prominent human rights cases. Efforts to provide accountability significantly declined during 2020, Human Rights Watch said. The United Nations Human Rights Council, at its session beginning February 22, should adopt a resolution upholding justice for serious international crimes in Sri Lanka and condemning ongoing abuses. Earlier, UN Human Rights Chief Michelle Bachelet called on states on Wednesday to impose targeted sanctions on former Sri Lankan military commanders implicated in alleged war crimes during the final year of a 26-year civil war that ended in 2009.
It has been 12 years since the armed conflict ended in Sri Lanka, and victims are still looking for justice and truth. And this report by the High Commissioner for Human Rights basically concludes that the domestic initiatives for accountability have repeatedly failed to deliver justice for victims.
The report says that since 2020, President Gotabaya Rajapaksa had appointed at least 28 serving or retired military and intelligence personnel to key civilian posts, including some implicated in United Nations reports in alleged war crimes and crimes against humanity during the final years of the conflict.
An igloo cafe in ski resort town of Gulmarg in India's Jammu and Kashmir has become the center of attraction for the people visiting the valley. The cafe built of snow is country's first and Asia's biggest igloo cafe.
Tourists in ski resort town of Gulmarg in India's Jammu and Kashmir have a new place to chill out. An igloo cafe that serves hot food and drink on tables made of ice and snow. Staff at Kolahoi Green Heights Hotel in Gulmarg took inspiration from Arctic shelters and added a few local touches, an arc door and patterns on the curved walls. The igloo holds four tables with enough room for 16 guests. The coronavirus pandemic badly affected the tourism and leisure industry in the Union Territory, but now crowds are gradually coming to its snowbound slopes to enjoy the winter.
Last night we discovered this beautiful cafe which is not found in India. It is a very rare sight, and before we could head on to Srinagar and start our daily city lives, we made a stop here and we are not disappointed. This is a beautiful and the most coldest place. We've been at minus 12.
Gulmarg is also favourite among tourists from across the country and abroad to try out different winter sports including ice skating, skiing, gliding and racing.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/isasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at isasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.